can't move. I'm running out of things to teach you. Maybe I'll just enjoy the show. Faster, Drifter! Nostalgic for our Wangin moment. Cool, you already know the car. But this one, what style? You're giving the competition a real fashion lesson. When you manage to drift this bulky bodywork, it's just magic. Tight drift for speed. Your choice. Both are impressive in their own way. Long slide incoming.
Congratulations, driver. On to the next one. Epilogue time. If you want to train one last time, follow Waimea Valley. The mountain road will take you to the climax. Icon. There is no other word for the next car. Besides being a natural-born drifter, this car is just the most precious thing in the world for your host. No need to say more. You already know the car and what it's capable of. We just couldn't go with any other car for the last drift versus street race. The RX-7, a drifting emperor.
Again. It's giving me goosebumps. That was a great move. Is ready to leave its nest. What more can I say? Well, maybe one thing. Show these guys what a true drifter is. Careful, there are a few more like that.
Thank you.
New playlist ahead. Let's go. Good choice. Ready to go? You've just signed in for Ocean and Sky, a playlist of a totally different kind. Ocean and Sky. Can you fly and sail as well as you drive? Let's see what's coming up. You're going to need a boat to access the first event. Use the fast bait vehicle switch and onward tow, sailor.
This is Sean Babalu.
And this is Bob Schwartz. We're talking to you live from Hawaii, where we'll be following yet another Motorfest series. A very special one, to say the least.
Indeed, no rubber or asphalt today. The competition you're about to follow is all about boats and planes. Ocean and sky.
Waves and wind.
That's right. And as you happen to be the boat specialist, Bob, the floor is all yours.
Thanks, Sean. Indeed, we're starting right off the bat with some serious inshore powerboat racing. The ocean is nice and flat, perfect for our competitors to show us how well they can handle these speedsters. If they use their trim right, they'll be able to push their machines to their maximum.
These things are fast, and I'm especially curious about that red trident-shaped boat right there. What model is that?
This peculiar one-seater, my friend, is another unique Motorfest creation. A compact yet aggressive speedboat, the Water Rocket.
Wow.
avoid those rocks.
Here, but I have to admit, this series is off to a good start. I see a lot of skills down there.
You're absolutely right, Sean. Plus, we've got Hawaii on its Sunday best. Careful, it may not last.
To reach the finish line. Hang in there, buddy.
That's water rocket, Sean. Try to keep up. We're off to a beautiful start. I didn't have my morning coffee, but with this kind of show, I don't think I'll need one.
Excellent warm-up, Bob. Now, let's fly.
First of many, I am sure. You've experienced the ocean. Now it's time to take to the skies. This is an opportunity to see the island like you've never seen before. Everything, everywhere, all at once.
This is Bob Schwartz and Sean Babalu. What's up, Sean?
All good here, Bob. The first airborne trial has started, as you all know. These are individual races against the clock, and we're currently following our standout contestant from earlier. Come on, Water Rocket. Show him what you got.
Well, it truly brings a tear to my eye to see you so enthusiastic, Sean. You sound like you've just hit your 40s again. So, what's your feeling on this?
The weather conditions still seem reasonable, allowing our pilots to take advantage of these nice wind currents without any real turbulence. I'm really curious to see how the up-and-coming Water Rocket will take advantage of that. Let's see how it'll turn out.
Do you really think the newbie stands a chance in this competition?
Trust me, Robert, I can feel it in my bones. As you can see, some of the risky segments here require flying real close to the mountains. Now following the ridge of the mountain.
A great spot for motocross. Off-roading addicts, this is for you.
And welcome to Hawaii.
Beechcraft Stagger Wing is truly a beautiful piece, isn't it? And a great choice for that flight.
If you take a look at its side, you'll notice that it bears an unusual negative wing stagger design, which means its upper wing is positioned behind the lower one.
Matter of visibility, I presume.
You're absolutely right, Bob, among other things. Watch closely, everyone. You don't see such a hot antique going all out like this every day.
Honolulu just appeared on the horizon. Oh, that's a great sight.
Here we are. This flight ends above the breathtaking Motorfest playground. A great time for the Stagger Wing and its promising pilots.
Well, I'm staggered.
great job, but the journey is far from over.